So we have shadows. I just want to explain what I'm doing, even though I already started recording. So we usually post videos when we do lectures up online. We use Google Classroom so that you guys can access these if you need while you're doing your work or while you're studying, or if you just really like the sound of my voice and want to go home and see me do another lecture. Juniper. Okay, title for today is Solving Inequalities. And no, this is not like your expedition. We're not going to be trying to solve all of the inequalities in the world. What I'm talking about are these inequalities, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to. And so these symbols, if you've never seen them before, are kind of like replacements for the equal sign. And we can use them in algebraic, not equations, because we don't have an equal sign, but in algebraic inequality. So again, this one here is the greater than symbol. This one is less than. And then this one is greater than or equal to. And this one is less than or equal to. So I'm going to start with some really simple illustrations of what this means using variables. So for example, if I just said x is greater than 7, what I'm saying is x, my variable, is any number bigger than 7. So could x be 7?
No.
No. Could x be 8?
Yes.
Could x be anything less than 8?
Yes.
What?
7.1, 7.2, 7.3.
Totally. So this includes, yeah, that's actually a really good point. There are actually an infinite number of numbers less than 8 that 7 could be, or that x could be, because I can keep adding zeros to my decimal, right? 7.01, 7.001, 7. So I can keep getting closer and closer to 7. And the way that we show this algebraically is we draw a number line. So let's say that 7's right here on my number line. That would mean this is 8. What number would this be?
6.
6, right? What number would that be?
5.
What number would this be?
9.
9, right? So I can draw a number line. This number line goes on forever. It doesn't end.
Well, it
doesn't, though. And I can show x is greater than 7 on here with basically drawing a line. So I'm going to say x is any number from here over. And to show that I'm not including the number 7, but I'm including every number above 7.
I know.
Do you know what we do?
Yeah, there's the little circle.
Uh-huh.
And if it's an open circle, that means that it is anything above the number, but if it is filled in, then it means it is 7 or anything above.
Yeah.
Can you try that double your
dad? All right. So if we have an open circle, that corresponds to the greater than or the less than without the equal to. What it's saying is we're starting at 7, but we're not including the number 7. So just as an illustration of that, if I had x is less than 7, I would draw my same number line, but I would still have an open circle, but my arrow would go that way, because those are the numbers that are less than 7. If I had x is greater than or equal to 7, I would draw the same number line. But now, right here, I'm going to put, I call it a solid dot, but it's filled in to show I'm starting at 7 and I'm including 7. X could even be 7 in this case.
7.7.
So then the last example would be x, sorry, almost did a. X is less than or equal to 7. Am I going to use a hollow dot or a solid dot here?
Solid.
Solid, because it could be equal to. Am I going to go to the left or the right?
Right, left.
The left, because those are the numbers that are less than 7. Okay. So now, we're going to get into actually the solving part of this. Okay, and I'm going to start that up here just in case you haven't written all that down yet. Let's say I have a problem like this. 2x plus 5 is greater than 10. What's your intuition? What are you thinking you would do to solve that problem? What would you probably do?
Right. Plug in anything. I'd probably put like in just 5, so that'd just be like 15.
Okay. So you would just start plugging in numbers. Okay, x could be 5, because when x is 5, then 2 times 5 plus 5 is greater than 10, because 10 plus 5, 15 is greater than 10. Awesome. One down, infinity to go.
Yep. Yay.
Riley?
Well, I would be guessing that x would be anything greater than 2, because I know that 5 times 2 is 10, and okay. It has to be greater than.
Nice. So just kind of basing on this, rather than saying something that x could be, could we just say what x has to be greater than?
Yeah.
So x could be anything greater than 2, because 2 times 2 is 4, plus 5 is 9. So, wait a second.
No, it would be
2 times 2 is 4. What if I had 2.1?
That'd be
2.1 times 2 is
4.2
plus 5 is
7.2.
9.
Is it?
No, it's 9. Let me ask you a different question. What if I gave you this problem? How do you solve that? 2x plus 5 equals 10. What do you do? What's your first step? Go for it, Stella. Nice. Subtract 5 from both sides. And what'd I do next? Ainsley?
Would you divide 5 by
2? Nice. So x is equal to 5 halves, which is also the number 2.5. That sounds really close to some of our estimates. Do you think if I just change this to greater than, would it still be true here? X has to be greater than 2.5?
Yeah.
So let's try this. So what we're saying is that if I have an inequality, I can solve it the same way I solve an equation. 3x minus 1 is equal to 8. But instead of equal to, I'm going to have less than 8. Okay, how do I solve that? What's my first step, do you think? What's one first step? Do you want to go say something? Hazel, what could I do first?
I'm probably going to ask something else.
You have a question?
Can I just go get water?
Yeah, go for it. What would I do to solve this? Pretend it's an equal sign. Right.
Well, I guess you could just like add to both sides, because it's just like...
What would I add to both sides?
1.
Nice. Right, so then I have 3x is less than 9. What would I do next? Ainsley?
Divide
9
divided by
3. So x is just less than 3. So that's the same process we've been using to solve equations, but we're solving an inequality. Does this actually work? What's a number that's less than 3?
2.
2. So let's say x is 2. That means 3 times 2 is 6. 6 minus 1 is 5. Is 5 less than 8?
Yeah.
So do you guys understand the advantage of this versus Rain's approach?
Mm-hmm.
What's the advantage here? I'm writing one thing. How many answers are there for x?
Infinite.
Yeah, there's like an infinite range of things that x could be. So rather than saying, well, x could be 2, and x could be 1, and x could be 0, and x could be negative 777, and negative 778, and -1,256,321, and -1,356,222. I can just say, no, x is just anything less than 3.
No.
Yeah.
Because, like, I was
going to
say, if you put 1 in x, it would still be less than 8.
Exactly. If I put anything less than 3 in, it's still going to be less than 8. So if I put 1 in, I get 3 times 1 is 3, minus 1 is 2, is less than 8. Right? And this is a really important realization, which is inequalities work a lot like equations. They work a lot like algebraic equations, and I can solve it. Now, the last step I'm going to do here is I'm going to draw out my number line, and I'm actually going to graph x is less than 3 on my number line. So remember, I use a hollow dot because there's not an equal to sign, and it's less than, so I'm going to go to all the numbers that are less than.
They got an early launch.
All right.